you, Chairman, and good afternoon, everyone. I'm Tomohiko Hojo at Tohoku University. Today, I'd like to talk about hydrogen embrittlement property of nitrogen-added triplated molten stick steel. First, I'm going to explain the background. recent decades, reduction of CO2 exhaust gases and improvement of impact safety are required for the vehicles. It is expected to apply high-strength steel to automotive structural parts such as pillars and frames. The first generation advanced high-strength steel, such as dual phase steel and complex phase steel, and second generation AHSS, such as austenitic and trip steel, have been developed. In the future, third generation AHSS with high tensile strength of 15 megapascal and total elongation of 20% will be developed and applied to the automotive structural steels. In the third generation AHSS,
is there some problem?
No, not working.
Come here.
Please.
It's
okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah. In the third generation AHSS, transformation induced plasticity, trip aided molten stick steels, TM steels containing a small amount of retained austenite is expected to apply that such structural steels with tensile strength of 15 megapascal grade and 20% of total elongation. This figure shows a relationship between hydrogen hydrogen concentration and tensile strength of steels. Hydrogen embrittlement may not occur in the steels with tensile strength below or lower than 1,000 megapascal, even though the high hydrogen concentration was a large amount of hydrogen was existed in the steels. On the other hand, when tensile strength exceeds 1,000 megapascal, a small amount of hydrogen can cause the occurrence of hydrogen embrittlement. So it is necessary to consider the hydrogen embrittlement in the automotive structural part.
Again.
Thank you. In addition, it has been reported that nitrogen addition to austenitic stainless steel increases yield and tensile strengths and improves the corrosion resistance. So it is expected that the addition, nitrogen addition to the TM steel increases the strength and improves the corrosion resistance and hydrogen embrittlement resistance. So for the objective in this study, the effect of nitrogen addition on hydrogen embrittlement property of TM steel were investigated using tensile testing with varied strain rate. Next, I'm going to explain the experimental procedure. In this study, three kinds of cold rolled steels with steel sheets with chemical composition, as shown here, are prepared. And nitrogen content of steels A, B, and C were 0, 100, and 200 mass ppm. The heat treatment of annealing at 950 degrees Celsius for 1200 seconds, and isothermal transformation treatment at 250 degrees Celsius for 1000 seconds are conducted to produce the TM steels. The hydrogen embrittlement test was carried out using the tensile specimen with 50 millimeter in gauge length, 6 millimeter in width, and 1.2 millimeter in thickness at cross-head speed of 0.1 to 100 millimeter per minute after hydrogen charging. Hydrogen charging was conducted by means of cathode charging using a solution of 3 weight percent sodium chloride and 5 gram per liter ammonium cyanate at a current density of 10 ampere square meter at 25 degrees Celsius for 48 hours before tensile test. Next, I'm going to explain the results. These figures show the nominal strain curves of steels A, B, and C tensile tested at low and high strain rate with that and with hydrogen. You can see that the fractured strain was decreased by the hydrogen absorption in all steels. But the stress strain response at the elastic region is almost same in with atom and with hydrogen. These figures show the variations in the total elongation as a function of strain rate in the steels A, B, and C with that and with hydrogen charging. You can see that the steels A, B, and C without hydrogen possessed a total elongation of approximately 15%, and steel B exhibits a slightly high total elongation without hydrogen charging. Total elongation without hydrogen slightly decreases with decreasing the total elongation without hydrogen charging. However, total elongation with hydrogen total elongation with hydrogen decreases with decreasing strain rate. Particularly, in steel C, steel C with hydrogen exhibited a low total elongation at a low strain rate. Next, these figures show the fracture surfaces of the TM steels without and with hydrogen tensile tested at low and high strain rates. You can see that when tensile test was conducted without hydrogen, all TM steels, the fracture surface of TM steels was covered by the fine dimples. On the other hand, the quartz cleavage fracture around the inclusions was observed in the steels B tensile tested at high strain rate and steels C tensile tested at high and low strain rate with hydrogen. So we are going to analyze the inclusions on the fracture surface of steels B and C EDX and EBSD analysis were conducted to the TM steels. The results are shown in this slide. According to the EDX analysis, the inclusion was composed of with the aluminum and nitrogen. In addition, according to the EBSD analysis of microstructure of as heat treated steel C, aluminum nitride precipitate were observed in the martensite matrix. In addition, hydrogen analysis were also conducted to the TM steels, and this figure shows the hydrogen evolution curves of TM steels. You can see that the hydrogen evolution desorption peak height was increased with increasing the nitrogen content. So it is suggested that the large amount of hydrogen was trapped at martensite matrix and aluminum nitride interfaces. So finally, I'm going to explain the hydrogen embrittlement mechanisms of TM steels. The microstructure of TM steel was microstructure of TM steels consisted of martensite matrix and fine retained austenite. In steels B and C, coarse aluminum nitride was precipitated. When TM steel was charged with hydrogen, hydrogen was trapped at matrix retained austenite interfaces, thus packet grain, prior austenite grain boundaries in steel A. In steel B and C, a large amount of hydrogen was trapped at the matrix aluminum nitride interfaces. When tensile test was carried out to the TM steels, void and crack initiations at the matrix and transformed martensite interfaces, loss packet and prior austenite grain boundaries are accelerated, and fracture surface dimples were observed on the fracture surface in steel C, steel A. On the other hand, in steel B and C, cracks initiated at the matrix aluminum nitride interfaces and coarse cleavage cracks propagated around the aluminum nitride. The total elongation of steel C was decreased by the hydrogen charging. In steel B, the decrease of total elongation of steel B was small in comparison with steel C. This result might be attributed to the small amount of absorbed hydrogen and the occurrence of small area of cleavage cracking. So finally, the conclusions are summarized as follows. Thank you very much for your kind attention.